Hi guys, Francisco Lin here, busy violin learner, and for this video I would just like to do something different. Yesterday, April the 19th, 2017, I went to Lindsay Sterling's Brave Enough tour here in Auckland, New Zealand at the Power Station, and I also went for the VIP meet and greet, and I would dare say that it is awesome. And as a thank you for following me on my violin journey, I would just like to let you in on the Q&A and meet and greet portion of the tour. So I hope you like it. Stay tuned.
Hi.
Off the side here, we've got Chris and Alan. Give it up for our standing back guys. And you stay in your cubby, Alan, okay? but does anyone have any questions for us? Any of us? Yes?
I was wondering if you're going to do any more like duets with any more metal singers like you did with Lucy Hale, like with Evanescence or something.
I love Amy Lee from Evanescence so much, so I would die to do something with her. But yeah, I mean, I like just collaborating and like doing things with lots of different styles of music. And I loved how the collaboration with Lizzie went, so I'd be open to it in the future.
Learning the violin, did you go through Suzuki books 1 to 10 or?
I didn't make it to 10. I switched teachers when I was at like 8 and they weren't into the Suzuki thing, so I went rogue after that.
I came to 8.
Cool. Yes.
What kept you motivated?
Kept me motivated. When I was a kid?
Yeah.
Now?
Just
in general, it keeps me motivated. The fact that I get to eat cereal at the end of every day. But I mean, now it's just the fact that I love what I do. I love that I get to be so creative with the violin, and that keeps me wanting to, you know, keep up my skill, but also keeps me wanting to push myself, try new things, work really hard in every aspect, whether it's business or music or, you know, physically staying in shape, and all those things are just driven by the fact that I genuinely love what I do. And, you know, as a kid, I really have always genuinely liked the violin, and even there were times, of course, though, when I wanted to quit when I was younger, and thankfully my parents, you know, encouraged me slightly strongly. Yeah, they were like, nope, we've been paying for these lessons, you cannot quit right now, and I'm grateful for that. My achievements I'm most proud of? Oh, that's a really good question. I'm gonna say my second album. Writing my second album, and I was so afraid to write again after my first album. I was like, was that just a fluke? I don't know. Writing has always been kind of a scary thing for me, and I was absolutely terrified to start that second album, wondering if I could live up to the first one. And it's probably my favorite album I've done. It was my second album, and I really like the story it tells. What's next? Christmas album. I'm starting to work on a Christmas album. I'm very excited about that. Again, I'm always nervous to write, so I'm a little nervous because I start literally the day after we get home. And there's a documentary film piece that we were working on last year, and it comes out this summer. So I'm really excited about that.
What was your favorite music video to do and why?
Roundtable Rival was super fun. I loved the dancing in it, I loved the costumes, like the set. It just felt like we were all like on a movie set, and it was a lot of fun. We actually were on a movie set.
What do you like about New Zealand?
New Zealand's
absolutely beautiful. I came here like 4 years ago, actually, when I filmed the Lord of the Rings video. I was here with Devin Graham, and I was like his assistant. I was helping him film things, and then I also brought a big white dress so that I could, while I was assisting him, grab a couple shots for my music video. New Zealand's just absolutely gorgeous. Next time I come, I really want to have some extra time so that I can go to the South Island because I've never been. I also really like that you guys have the Shire here. I know you say the Hobbits, you know.
Hobbit.
Yes. I went there the first time I came to New Zealand and loved it.
If you could choose a book world to live in, which would it be?
A book world? Yeah. Oh, Harry Potter. Yes. Think about that one. Yeah. Oh, but my music video is on Blu-ray? Several people have asked about that. I kind of was like, oh, because of YouTube, who would want these on, you know? But I guess like multiple people have asked, so maybe it's something I should actually think about doing. For Christmas album and Lindsay Sterling DVD. Yeah. All right. Any last questions? Yeah.
Would you ever consider being the music for film? And if so, what kind of films would you like to do that for?
Ooh. Yes. The answer is I would love to compose for film, and I think something. You know, like if I could compose for anything, it would be like a Pirates of the Caribbean or a Harry Potter, like something very fantastical and, you know, fantasy, very costume, period piece driven. It would definitely be my ideal world to compose for. Super fun. It's on my bucket list. All right. We're going to play you guys a song now. We're going to do Take Flight. This song was written about hope and what, you know, kind of the feeling that comes along with, you know, that time maybe we're in, maybe you can't quite see the light at the end of the tunnel and you don't know how much farther you're going to have to push, but then you see that little light and it's that feeling of hope is what I was trying to capture in this song.
Thank you. I don't even know what I was thinking of. I was just like off, seeing like colors.
So you don't remember playing the song?
I don't even remember like
the journey.
Well, it was crazy, like.
Anyways, it's a nice spaced out.
No, I got lost in the song. The magic of music.
There it is.
Anyways, Drew just put a terrible negative spin on my magic moment. Anyways, thank you guys for coming to our meet and greet, and we're going to go get ready, and we'll see you soon for the show.
So that was it. I hope you liked it, even if the resolution and documentation and angles are not perfect. I should have made a disclaimer in the beginning that it would be an amateur footage because I am an amateur at everything. Parenting, filming, editing, shooting the videos, and playing the violin. But it was awesome. So I just thought that you might like it, and I just want to share with you my inspiration for learning. And I just really love Lindsey Stirling to bits. So see you in the next video. It'll be another progress video in the next month. Stay tuned, and thank you for subscribing and following me on my violin journey. Hi guys, this is Frances.
Okay.
Because you've been so good, and you like to share with you Lindsey Stirling's VIP meet and greet.